All right, here we are. It is Monday. And I got an email from the local insurance company said that my check was returned. $10 fee for Well, it's nice and sunny today. Little February weather. We're having our Indian summer. Scootaloodle-doo, 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 Yanni. So here we are, just relaxing and being here in the present moment. No worries, no fears. No rush. Or no, let's change that. See, those are what you call negative affirmations. They aren't as powerful as positive affirmations. As far as law of attraction goes. So let's just say this. I'm feeling peaceful. Feeling relaxed, feeling settled. Big difference. See that? Look at that. Look at how our natural reflex tends to speak negative affirmations. Kind of reminds me of a negative affirmation. How about a positive affirmation? I am the creditor. You have 3 days to respond. 3 but my affidavit. You have 3 days to respond. But my affidavit to response. Creditor. There, look at that. Positive. Now, how do we mix spirit and body with negative and positive affirmations? Let's see here. We know that. Know that positive is thought and negative is body. Know that all thought has a positive and a negative side to it, or a male and a female side to it. We know that the body also has a male and a female side to it. Transparency. We don't have to be all totally transparent at this point in time in the age that we live in. Remember, when you're totally transparent, you're 100% spirit. And 100% spirit has no body. This is my in the present moment video. Been doing some reminders of being my thoughts on my body. Even my thoughts on my body, so that my body is feeling healthy and whole. Keeping my thoughts on any pain signals in my body. Most significant pain center in my body that I'm going to heal with thoughts is the root chakra burning. Form of called tension myotis syndrome. All that is just a result of the clenching of butt cheeks from being spanked as kids through the generations. We were not made to be spanked. We were made to be born whole and healed and well and healthy and smart and wise and knowledgeable and understanding. All pain cannot collect from my health. I have a security agreement and a commercial lien. I have the agreement of the corporation that they cannot collect body. Therefore, all discomfort, all disease cannot collect from my body. All discomfort and all diseases are connected to thought. Thoughts are looking for us to identify with them. Thus, when we do identify with our thoughts, those thoughts attach emotions to us. Now, when we're thinking in the river of life, I can see how it's beneficial to wait for complete sentences, to wait for ideas to form in the mind before we speak. This is what we call writing it on the tablet of our heart. Past videos, I have been impatient because I wanted to get everything on record, every little detail, while it was fresh in my mind. And I noticed that caused a lot of tension and a lot of haste and anxiety. Like having somebody stand opposite of you and move their arms and legs and ask you to follow and mirror their movements. That would be like giving that person standing across from us who initiates the moves, be like giving him jurisdiction. Whereas we gathered, if we were to just sit here and gather all the thoughts together, analyze them, put names to them, or label the thoughts, they label the thoughts, we label them as good thoughts or bad thoughts. They're either female thoughts or male thoughts. They're negative or positive thoughts. What we want to do is have a balance between the two, a mix of both negative and positive. So the negative would be the observing of the thoughts, because for every desire that we look to manifest in our life is the result of a contrasting negative thought. So therefore, we constantly have before our eyes the negative and the positive. And we are constantly creating our own realities moment by moment on automatic pilot. Becoming aware of this is essential. For instance, if we go to the supermarket and we bring our food to the counter and we're interacting with the cashier, we realize that anything we say, any body action that we portray, is interpreted by the cashier. Thus, in the moment, we are actually creating our reality with our words, our actions, and our intentions. I'm starting to notice that more so the power of our intentions. Because we could be giving the cashier money for payment over the counter for grocery goods, and as we hand the green money over to them and put it in their hand, if we have any thoughts of ridicule, like saying to ourselves in our mind, man, sure is an ugly looking cashier. Well, right there in the present moment, that vibration is actually picked up by the cashier. That's what you call their third eye. Their third eye reads our minds. Our third eye reads each other's minds. All that is just when you walk up to someone, you can feel their vibrations. You can pretty much tell what they're thinking just by their body actions. Their body language shows us that they're standoffish, which means they're more than likely full of thoughts of unfavorable thoughts towards you. They're afraid of you. They're not sure of themselves. Lack confidence in who they are. They have yet to enter into that expressing their intentions and their thoughts to have love feelings go through their mind. Because you have to think to yourself, if you're standoffish and your body language shows that you're standoffish, that's an imbalance. That's a discomfort. That's self-injury. Because you want to remain balanced in the middle, able to freely move side to side, leaning in trust side to side. And the more you practice sending love into the air in all your relationships and all your people encounters, like getting gas at the gas station, you practice putting into the atmosphere thoughts of love, thoughts of uplifting, thoughts of appreciation, thoughts of thankfulness, thoughts of learning, thoughts of getting along, thoughts of being easygoing. If you put all these wonderful thoughts in the air, then the person that you're dealing with right there will, or a group of people that you're dealing with, they can feel that. You feel that through their third eye automatically. Just naturally feel at ease. They feel good about themselves in your presence. All because you were the initiator to set your light on a candlestick for all to see. Everyone sees that light using their third eye. It's called a natural intuition toward good vibrations. People also can use that intuition toward the negative. Their third eye will pick up negative intentions from other people. So if you're feeling negative intentions being put into the air by other people, then you can zero out that account by putting your polar opposite intentions into the air of love. And that'll bring things to a balance in the middle. It's kind of like the old saying, like attracts like. Well, on the other hand, also, and just as effective, opposites attract too. This is where you can bring things to negotiations and then find a middle ground, a compromise. That's all zero balance is. It's a compromise. It's an agreement of compromise. It says, oh, I can handle this much, and the other person says, I can handle this much, so let's be smart about this and make it beneficial for both of us so that we both have a win-win situation. We both feel good about the decision. We both feel good about the agreement. And sometimes we have to negotiate that back and forth until we do reach that good agreement. Now, when we're entering into the rushing rapids of thought, these are the thoughts that are contrast for us. So the rushing rapids of thought are a good thing. But when we pull out our identification card and we give the thoughts jurisdiction over us, then they feel the necessity to stick an emotion to us. And that emotion can be harmful and self-injurious. And most of the time, it causes our bodies to tense up. Like I said, Dr. Sarno, John E. Sarno, says that we can cure ourselves just by giving ourselves knowledge. Knowledge that is the cure-all for everything is the security agreement and the commercial lien. All of our pain is centered around being in prison planet, under the assumptive jurisdiction of thought. Thought has taken the manifestation of people, such as the public attorney, who oversees all jurisdiction for those who submit to the corporate jurisdiction. Those who rebut the assumption, they can now enter into rest. Start allowing their bodies to heal all by their own thoughts. Understand that that claim of lien stand the security agreement side of it. See that no corporate person can collect person, which is my all capitalized name. And not only do corporate persons cannot collect, but corporate ideas, such as pain, depression, sadness, fear, anger, ultimately death. Because in the prison system, you are pretty much forced to slave labor, and that's a painful situation. But keep in mind that Mother Nature put the prison planet system into place to teach us to be peaceful and self-regulating, to be safe. We learn how to do this in combination with our international peace treaty, our security agreement and commercial lien. implies that this international peace treaty is a declaration of individual as an of an individual nation among all the nations of. Then we realize that we are the king of our body, and our body is composed up of trillions of corpuscles known as protons. So we have to rehabilitate ourselves. We have to reprogram them and teach them how to set themselves free through using that claim of leanness. Self-talk, to talk to ourselves and remind us, either with our thoughts under our breath, or we can speak it out verbally. Now, part of self-injury is gluttony. Gluttony is just another word for overbalance, out of balance, too much of one thing. When we do too much of one thing, we injure ourselves. Stay up too long without proper sleep. Then, without the proper knowledge of thought, how to direct our thoughts to keep us healthy all the time, whether we sleep or not, because it is possible to live without sleep, and we'll be able to do this. But for the sake of our conditions that we're in right now, we're slowly moving toward that, and if we don't get enough sleep, the body tends to get tired, and perform our tired body, well, have an emotion attached to it, and a feelings attached to it, which are so if we just realize that we're not feeling good and we desire to feel good, well, feeling tired, it makes us want to shut our eyes. Rest. Makes us want to take a nap. No. Constantly tired all the time and working a job where we have to go to work tired all the time, well, then we want to use that job as a contrast to reality. And we project our thoughts to our present moment. We can have thoughts of I'm gonna make a goal to become self-employed. I'm gonna try to become self-employed and work at home, so I can work my own hours and sleep whenever I want. Or you can make it a goal to learn private maritime law so that you don't have to work a job at all. Everything that you do is for the benefit of the planet, because ocean highway these days. Top mode of getting information to people. All we gotta do is do videos or have live rooms we can go into, and we can share information and we can teach people the knowledge that we know as lien claimants or secured party creditors. So this is actually becomes a natural thing that we love to do, and we don't have to work jobs no more. And those who are still in Prison Planet, they will work the jobs, and they will keep all of the food and the distributing trucks going, and slowly start to incorporate animals into our cities like India. We will learn how to make rivers of pollution and clear rivers, and we will learn to drink from those rivers like they do in India and build our immune systems up. Drink with the animals and eat out of the same dishes as the animals to share our saliva, and there will be no more diseases. Fighting, there will be no more jealousy, there will be no more saying, oh, share and share alike. So yeah, the internet, these YouTube videos, and live chat rooms are the wave of the future. Sharing knowledge. Secure party creditors will be sharing knowledge on the internet freely, and helping all those who are still in the prison system, helping them to sign themselves out. To use the International Monetary Fund as the currency. Life is really that simple. It does take expression of desire to get there. You have to actually get on the computer and type up your security agreements and your commercial liens. Title. To all the pays for all the resources of the land. I'm feeling pretty good. I ain't tense. My tailbone's not burning. I'm just sharing information on the internet. if you want to call this a job, this would be my job. But it's not the traditional job. It is a I do. These days, all celebrities, live chat rooms, all we can enter their rooms and they up and appreciative and creating our own reality. Person can collect from you your favorite disease. Ultimately, even death can balance of body and spirit. By that there ain't no need to be the observer of life and watch before you. Be the essence of the Muji video. Although, be part of my intention. All people on Earth will get their commercial lien. Prison planet, so that they can have their eternal. But the law of correspondence, as above, so below, in your life. Power to of riding the rapid river rafters, about 10 people in one of those rafts, and one guy at the end, but, and he's steering path. Thoughts. He's able to steer himself through those contrast dropped right back into the river of life at his will. He can cause this to happen right in his own imagination. Fork in the road. Fork back in with the main river again. Throughout the day, you might practice your skills. Riding the rapids of your negative thoughts, negative. Keeping yourself out of the jurisdiction of by way of reminding yourself. Or with your thoughts, or you can speak it out loud. Person, nor no corporate emotion or corporate ideas. Art. So it is. Manifest in life. So if you learn Roberts. Top two most fearful things. But everyone in the planet will learn. Party creditors are still employed so that they can have paper. Paper money. And to and ultimately to become an international private banker so that you could own money and have that money exchanged at the international, so that people who like to use different types of paper piece of paper and write on it or color on it. Reference to your commercial lien. People can use. Life is really that simple. That's the way it's. System anymore, because talents with each other, and we will take care of the animals. That their goats were their and so they snow leopards were contained so that none of the goats were eaten, so that the goats felt safe. To take care of their bodies, to keep their bodies. Necessity in the evolution of mankind, phase of evolution, which is keep our bodies warm with our thoughts. things get done. How to sign them. Secure party creditor. Security agreement in the commercial lien recorded. Retail products on the shelf. Come down the line is called bracelet. Poof. Instant access. Bracelet will have all technology is already here. So and life will be much more easier. So we wean ourselves off the bracelet, everything will be run from our brains with our thoughts. All we have to do is just think into the 2, you can test that to see how far you can stand in it. Thing, and I found nobody can collect taxes, and the county taxes, nothing. Apply to me, and they have sent letters in the mail saying that they have judgments against me and that I owe them test to see if I will standing my ground. I have now given the banks standing orders, Terry, standing orders to enforce my money. I did create my own money. And I'm supposed to exchange it at the currency exchange center. Turn it into Federal Reserve debt notes that they like. And put those debt notes in my account. What else? Just go ahead and connect me to the ATM system. Just hit the easy button. Those were the standing orders I gave to the international military. Department. They're the people with the guns who oversee the money. Connection to the United States. It has connection to the international military. Dishonors to the Criminal Investigation Department and investigate why the bank is dishonoring. Countdown here. 10, 9,